I know people who know me, they probably going to think that I'm homering, but I'm going to let my man start off first with this. I'm going to let Jeff talk first about it, and then I'm going to see what he has to say, and then I'll put my two cents in. But none other than the Cleveland Browns, 7-10 last year. Deshaun Watson came in week 12. The Browns were kind of in a playoff position at that point. But you know what? The Browns had already kind of made up their mind that we want to have Deshaun on a full season. And if we make the playoffs, cool. If we miss the playoffs, no worries. You know, pretty much we got our quarterback of the future. And what they did was they made a lot. They created a lot of excitement going into this year with the way that they with the players that they have on the roster. What are your thoughts on Cleveland this year?
You know, I was starting to get lathered up on Cleveland. In our projections, in fantasy, Deshaun was one of the sneaky quarterbacks. The addition of Elijah Moore from the Jets. Nick Chubb now has not to worry about Kareem Hunt. He has left the building. They drafted a rookie who's a little nicked up right now, Jerome Ford. Amari Cooper, Njoku, they have a good offense. Everyone's waiting for Deshaun to make the next step. Well, he's not progressing as quick as they thought he was. Another pedestrian week of practices, and the Browns tied the Eagles in a meaningless preseason game last night, 18-18, on two missed field goals, by the way. So my point is, I think the Browns are the sexy pick. I really do. And anyone believing in the Browns, I don't have a problem with it. But if I got to put my stake and stance on a team to shock this division, it's coming up.
Oh, and well, you know, which got shocked the division. And I'm over here, I'm messing with Nephew right now because I thought he was talking Chiefs, but we had somebody else talking Chiefs. But we were talking AFC North and NFC North, so you guys come on in and talk to us in a few weeks when we talk in the West and everything like that, because today it's not about the Chiefs, okay? And I got a little surprise for you when we talk Chiefs as well, too. All right, so wins over under 9.5. This is a lot for the Browns, dude. You know that. And division championship is at 3-1 plus 310. And pretty much the whole situation here for me is like this. The Browns have the team in place. There is no more excuses. There is no way of saying that, oh, we were missing this because we didn't have a quarterback, or we were missing this because we didn't have a wide receiver, or we didn't have a running back. The Browns have one of the best offensive lines in the NFL. It's been graded as – PFF has seen them as the best offensive line going into this season. And they've been ranked in the top five for the last 3 years. And in one of those years, the Browns made the playoffs. So now you have a quarterback that the whole city can trust. That was the biggest problem, that Baker couldn't be trusted by the city. He was trusted by the organization. It's just the city has to have say into the situation as well, too. And that's the biggest downfall of the Browns. And the same thing goes for the Raiders. It's where you have too many mouthy fans. They already wanted to cut the kicker, and the kicker made three kicks last night, but he missed the most important one, the one to win the game last night. So, yeah, we got to cut him because he was drafted in the sixth round, and he's not hitting kicks like Justin Tucker. Hey, you know what? I saw Janikowski come to the league, and Janikowski missed his first six field goals in the NFL. And then the field goal that he hit was a 59-yard game winner in Kansas City. We all looked up and said, we'll be fine. Because now you guys are starting to realize kicking a field goal might be one of the toughest things that you do in life ever. So, you know, kind of back it up just a little bit, because if you can't kick the ball 50 yards down the field, then you can't really talk. That's the whole thing. So I feel that the Browns are on the brink, but you can't sit here and get so excited about potential It's been like this for the last 5 years with the Browns. But that just goes to show you that they have a coach in place that is geared towards winning. It's crazy that Stefanski actually has been the longest tenured coach in the Cleveland Browns return history. Think about that, Jeff. He's probably the longest tenured coach since Romeo Crennel. And he's won more games than Romeo Crennel as well, too. Romeo Crennel got to stick around because Romeo was just a great leader of men. But the biggest problem was is that they had an egotistical general manager in Savage, and they had a silly owner in Lerner. So it could never work. But if you would have gave us Romeo about another 2 or 3 years, the Browns could have probably been a very successful team because they built a foundation. You know what I mean? And I feel like with Stefanski, they've finally been able to build a foundation. So that's why the expectations are right where they need to be at. And the Browns, that they too are in a make or break season, in my opinion, because the Haslams have spent the money. They spent money on Chubb. They spent money on Cooper. They spent money on Watson to ensure that this team can get to the playoffs and be a viable Super Bowl contender. And it all happens with the defense stepping it up, in my opinion. The defense has to be the calling card this year. The offense, you can't rely on them to be great. You have to rely on the defense to be your calling card, because when you have a great running game like the Browns do, then the defense needs to be the star of the show. And I feel like that's what has to happen for the Browns to really take the next step. Your defense has to be top 10, not top 15, not top 20, not bottom 32. Top 10, Jeff. Top 10. And I'm not talking about at 10. I'm talking about 5, 6, 7, where you know every week that, hey, this might be a tough game. And the Browns showed a little bit of that last night with some pretty hungry players. They got safeties last night. They had 3 sacks in the first half. So there's a lot of things to be excited about if you're a Cleveland Browns fan. But you also, as a Cleveland Browns fan, you also have a lot to worry about. So that's just another year with the Browns. But all in all, they're 1-1-1 in the preseason, and they played 3 very impressive games. And I'm telling you right now, Deshaun, you better watch your back, because DTR, the city's falling in love with them, and the guy has shown that these scouts don't know ish about scouting no damn quarterback position. I'm telling you now. You know, it's hard to pass up on a guy that started 41 games, Jeff, in college, for a guy that – maybe started 6, but he got all the physical attributes. So, you know, somebody told us he could be like Mahomes, and that's we going to just run with that. You know, bad mojo. I said, for every Patrick Mahomes, there's Josh Freeman.
Oh, yeah.
Same exact person, same exact player. Just one got one had a 30-year-old coach. The other one had a 65-year-old coach.
Amen.
You know, but let's any last words on the Browns before we move?
No, I mean, the number set at 9.5 versus an 11.5. Again, they want you to bet the under here. If the Browns is going to succeed, I can see them going over. I can see them winning the division. I just not seeing it now. The progression that I needed to see from Watson, all the pieces, as you said, are in place. Maybe it's a 2-2 start. Maybe that's what it is. You know, do they upset Cincinnati, which is now down to close to a pick 'em? I think they're going to beat Cincinnati, to be honest with you, week one. Do they build off of that? Do they come out of the gates 3-1? The pieces are there. The over 9.5 is there. The plus 310 is there. I'm just going to put my flat. Listen, I think the Ravens win the division, gun to head. I do. But I'm going to shock the world in about 2 minutes.
All right. I like it. And you know what? I can see, and once again, I can see Jeff's getting a little antsy.